play stupid.
Quit it. Run, Forrest, run!
Hey, did you hear me, stupid?
Run, Forrest.
Get in the truck, get in the truck. Let's move it. Come on, let's get in the way, move it.
Run, Forrest, run!
Used to be, I ran to get where I was going. I never thought it would take me anywhere. Who in the hell is that?
That there is Forrest Gump, Coach. Just a local idiot.
And can you believe it? I got to go to college, too.
Federal troops enforcing a court order integrated the University of Alabama today. Two were admitted, but only after Governor George Wallace had carried out his symbolic threat to stand in the schoolhouse door.
Governor Wallace, I take it from that statement that you're going to stand in that
door. What's going on?
Coons are trying to get into school.
Coons? Well, raccoons trying to get on our back porch. Mama just chased them off with a broom.
Not raccoons, you idiot. And they want to go to school with us.
With us? They do?
Shortly after Governor Wallace had carried out his promise to block the doorway, President Kennedy ordered the Secretary of Defense then to use military force. Here by videotape is the encounter by General Graham, Commander of the National Guard, and Governor Wallace.
Because these National Guardsmen who are here today as federal soldiers are Alabamians, and they live within our borders. They are our brothers. We are winning in this fight. Because we are awakening the American people to the dangers that we have spoken about so many times, which is so evident today, the trend toward military dictatorship in this country.
And so at day's end, the University of Alabama in Tuscaloosa had been desegregated, and students Jimmy Hood and Vivian Malone had been signed up for summer classes.
Ma'am, you dropped your book. Ma'am.
Governor Wallace did what he promised to do. By being on the Tuscaloosa campus, he kept the mob from gathering and preventing.
Wasn't that Gump?
No, that couldn't be. Sure as hell was.
Now, a word